Hi, my name is Alex. I'm a web developer and photographer from Stockholm. Today there are about 60 million refugees fleeing from war, poverty, starvation and oppression. When they come to what they hope will become their new homes, their new home countries, they're often met with disgust and xenophobia and even violence. I believe this is due to lack of interaction between the refugees and the citizens of the country they arrive in. Many have tried to tackle this task, some through digital media, but not have made an application which is simple enough and internationally understandable. This is where Borderless comes in, a simplistic mobile app for iOS and Android. A recent study made by Penn State University showed that about 86% of Syrian refugees own a smartphone. And so I thought that a lightweight mobile app would be the perfect medium to reach them when they arrive in their respective countries, like Sweden for example. The vision behind the Borderless app was not only that I wanted to fight xenophobia, but also help the newly arrived refugees feel welcome in their new home. A country that is free, without oppression and without war, where they can feel safe, find new friends and integrate into society. Let me grab a coffee and I'll show you how it works.
You sign up with either your email or password or using your Facebook or Google account. When signed into the app, you will have your settings where you can change the language, edit your profile notification settings, among other things. I have mine set up in English, but a wide array of languages are available to ease the use for refugees from across the globe. Worth noting is that for the sake of it, my account is set up as a refugee account, meaning that I want to meet people who have lived in Sweden for some time and know their way around. If I had my account set up as a long-time citizen, I would only befriend people who are refugees. When you set up your profile, it's advised that you write your bio in the different languages you speak so that people who want to learn more about you can understand what your text says. Take Bob here for example. He says that he's an Arab man from Israel and he speaks Swedish, Hebrew and Arabic. If I click his picture, I can read more about him and his interests. However, I want to meet someone who speaks English, or otherwise we wouldn't be able to communicate. So I'll press the minus on him, even though I'm sure he's a nice guy. Okay, so here we have Jimmy. Jimmy speaks English and looks like an overall cool dude, which is perfect. I too like meatballs and to play guitar, and he also speaks English. He seems like a guy I would like to hang out with, so I'll press the plus. You have befriended Jimmy. Now Jimmy will be on my friend list and I can start chatting with him by pressing the button below. I'll go ahead and send Jimmy a message. What should I write? I'll write, hi. Now if I press this button up here, I will go to my friend list and find all the people I befriended and chatted with. Like Audrey and Alicia, and now Jimmy shows up as well. And also, if I want to find a specific person, I will just search using this search function for Rihanna, for example. And I will just search and I will find her, and there you will see that we have planned a meeting and we'll see each other maybe later today. All the button design have been chosen because of their international standard, like you have the handshake for meeting new people, the group of people for friends, and the plus and minus, which are international signs.
For marketing purposes, we thought we could contact refugee centers and put up posters, and from there on rely on word of mouth for it to spread. The basic idea behind the Borderless app is that you can find people quickly and meet them and do lighthearted things if you want to. Take a cup of coffee, stroll around Kungsträdgården, go see a movie, or something else, do whatever you want. While there are similar apps, they often require more engagement or more time consuming, which I believe makes it less attractive for ordinary people. With Borderless, you don't have to meet with anybody if you don't want to. You can just chat with them for a while, or meet them one time for an hour. The point is that it's easy to use and more people will use it, and that is how we'll help integrate newly arrived to an open and free world.